阅读、科技、旅行，生活可以很大，对话设计、学习思考不嫌太多。这里是 iTunes 获奖播客狗熊有话说，一听就停不下来的哦。Hello， 大家好，这里是独立知识型脱口秀狗熊有话说 Bear Talk， 我是大狗熊。上期我们在分享读书的感受心得的时候呢，我和大家分享过一本略显沉重的书，叫 Man's Search for Meaning by Victor E. Frankl， 奥地利的心理学家维克多写的《人类寻找生命的意义》。那么这本书啊，略显沉重，但今天我要和大家分享这本书呢，就是完全相反的一个极端。它的书名叫做《The Subtle Art of Not Giving a Fuck》。那么听名字你就知道是一本这个，感觉好像很轻松或者说很魂不吝的一本书了。嗯，它的名字翻译过来呢，可以叫做，他妈不在乎的精妙艺术。之前其实我在今年开始的时候采访了创意公司叫做 Rome 的一位设计总监Lucas。 那么那期播客其实反响还特别高啊。那么在采访他的时候呢， Lucas 说过一句话，说我们现在很多人啊，喜欢选择自己想要的生活方式，我要当歌星，我要当网红，我要当什么什么什么什么，但却很少会有人去选择，或者说很少有人会想到要去选择相应的 struggle， 也就是你要接受的困扰和挑战。那么要当歌星，你要面对自己的这种不确定性的高风险，然后超低的成功几率和没有获得这个相应认可之前的那种心理焦虑，没有人会在意，会很少有人会在意这些。那么其实要选择自己的 struggle 比你选择自己的 lifestyle 要更重要一些。当时我觉得这个家伙哇 Lucas 好有深度，但直到我读完了这个今天推荐的这本书 The Subtle Art of Not Giving a Fuck 之后，我才发现原来 Lucas 说的这句话出处在这本书里。所以读书呢的确可以让你的谈吐更有气质。那么说一下这本书啊， The Subtle Art of Not Giving a Fuck， 它的作者叫做 Mark Manson。 那么 Mark Manson 呢是美国著名的博客作者，这样说感觉好像听起来不是太有趣啊。那么 Mark Manson 啊，他是个泡妞专家他的其中的一个身份叫做Dating coach， 也就是泡妞顾问啊，这个约会顾问。那么他出生在一个中产阶级家庭，其实家里面还算有点钱，但从小呢就不喜欢循规蹈矩的生活啊，喜欢所有年轻人都喜欢一些东西，瞎混啊，泡妞啊，然后这个混不吝啊，等等等等啊。直到他最好的一个朋友，好哥们儿啊，这个因为跳水意外丧生，应该是在他高中的时候吧。然后彻底改变了他的人生态度，那么他开始认真的为了自己去学习，然后疯狂去读书，但呢继续坚持泡妞。那么到了24岁，工作一两年以后，发现自己受不了朝九晚五的工作呢，就考虑开始创业，那么选择互联网创业。那么串了半天好像没怎么创成，最后他还是开了个博客，然后写自己关于情感啊这个人生，变成了一个人生导师，那么开始写自己泡妞心得呀等等。但就那么巧啊，那么他就变成了一个情感专家，就像那种我也不是说像陆琪那种吧，反正就是段位要高很多了，就是一个网络的这个情感专家，然后博客就大红。那么在上面卖自己的这个书呀什么的，也顺利转型成为一个数字游民。再之后呢结婚，然后搬到纽约去定居，不再泡妞了。对了，这哥们儿呢 是1984年出生的，比大狗熊还年轻，那么让我感觉很叹气啊，他都是纽约时报畅销书榜的作家了。那么就像刚刚说的，这本书 The Subtle Art of Not Giving a Fuck 是可以翻译为关于去他妈的啊，不在乎的微妙艺术。那么听他的书名你就知道是一个魂不吝的风格。那么也会让你觉得 Mark 这个人是不是对什么都他妈不在乎啊，但读上几章你就会发现他其实每个人都有自己在乎的事情。那么 Mark 在这本书里面其实更多讲的是如何去 give a fuck， 也就是如何去在乎那些，或者说如何去认清你在乎的那些有价值的事情，如何去找到你的所谓的价值，你的 value， 找到之后呢，对其他事情就去他妈的啊， give a fuck， don't give a fuck。 那么在书里其实这本很像博客风格的一本书，因为每个章节其实都是独立的一篇散文。讲有的章节呢是用案例来开始，有的章节呢是作者自己的感受或者是自己作者经历的故事。但我特别喜欢其中有一些关于其他的一些事情，那么作者他讲了一些故事，那么会有一种怎么说呢，在描述本身和这个故事本身对你的启发来说，我觉得让我看到了一些自己以往没有意识到的东西。其中有三个故事让我印象很深。第一个故事是关于日本的，日本在战败之后，那个当时天皇说投降了，对吧，那么日本所有的这个军人都放弃抵抗了，但在分布的战场，比如说像在菲律宾的这个战场的丛林里面呢，有一位日本士兵呢就一直在坚持战斗。那么在天皇投降了20多年，他继续在坚持做这个丛林中做游击，时不时去这个搞破坏啊，去这个把房子烧掉呀之类的，反正就是还存在在这个丛林里面。那没有人能找到他，后面大家都知道这个人，但是就是找不到他，因为他一直躲在丛林里面。那么直到后面是另外一位日本青年，这个青年呢是一个非主流，不愿朝九晚五，然后是一个怎么说呢，就是跟现代的这个价值格格不入的，跟传统意义上上班族格格不入的一个青年。那么他就去应聘说啊，让我去找这个日本老兵吧，那么这个工作听起来像个冒险一样的。结果巧就巧在出动了很多士兵，很多专业的搜查队都没有找到这个日本的军人。结果呢是这个非主流的这个待业青年找到了他。他们俩的生活出现了一个奇妙的交集。那么这个坚持武士道传统精神的老兵和这个非主流的这个青年呢，感觉像是八竿子打不着的关系，但是他们的生活呢也出现了，建立了一种奇妙的友谊，然后两个人出现了一个交集。之后老兵回到日本成为传奇，但他看到自己誓死保护的那种价值观，武士道的价值观在日本已经不复存在了，那么万念俱灰，他没有办法和那个社会融入，其实就像这个青年无法和社会融入一样。最终青年找到这位老兵可能也是有一定的缘分啊。那么后面这个老兵万念俱灰，最后去了巴西，死在那里，没有在日本继续生活。我就不讲述自己的理解了，大家可以感受一下这个故事背后的一些意思。那么第二个故事我觉得对我的感受特别的直接。第二个故事是关于两个被乐队踢掉的人。那么有两个人啊，可以说是有相同的遭遇。第一个呢是一个年轻的叫做 Dave 的一个小伙儿啊，那么他在加入了一个乐队，然后这个走了一段时间，然后这个乐队成绩还不错。突然有一天呢，经纪人就提出这个乐队其他成员一致通过，就是觉得你不适合我们乐队，然后就相当于就把他这个踢出去了。 Kyushu 呢也没有给他一些很具体的原因，或者说这个让他感觉到非常的不公。那么这个青年就开始继续的努力啊，就是想证明一下自己啊，虽然你把老子踢出去了，老子一样能够这个在这个音乐这个领域面闯出一方天地。那么这个青年又成立了一个同样类似风格的乐队，那么销量取得了非常巨大的成功。但很可惜呢，把他踢出去这个乐队叫做 Metallica 啊，是重金属乐队的老大。那么他后面成立了这个乐队叫做 Megadeth， 那 Megadeth 呢销量全球销量也超过这个应该是到多少呢？ Megadeth 3800万的这个全球总销量，我的天。那么就是相当于他所有专辑 Megadeth 所有专辑全球加起来有3800万，就3800万的这个销量。但是当媒体采访 Dave， 这个人叫做 Dave Dave Mustaine， 那么当媒体采访他的时候，他在这个电视访谈的时候哭得一塌糊涂，说自己仍然非常不快乐，然后被这个乐队踢出去，他仍然在心里耿耿于怀，然后一直是他心里的阴影。也就是说，他3800万的销量，在别的搞音乐的人来说已经是天文数字，对于他来说，他依然没有达到自己的这个成就。但另外一个人就很有意思，另外一个人呢，同样的也是和这个Dave Mustaine 一样的经历。那么他被自己乐队开除，然后被开除之后呢，他也没有能够很好的找到这个就是成立乐队啊什么的。那么把他开出去的这个乐队之后呢，成为全世界第一的这个乐队，也就是把他踢出去这个乐队叫做 Beatles 披头士。那么开除的这个人叫做 Pete Best 啊 ，Pete Best 是甲壳虫乐队的披头士乐队的这个第一批的成员。那么甚至有媒体或者说后面有音乐爱好者把他称为是披头士乐队的第五个成员，因为他虽然是早期的成员，但是对整个乐队的风格影响特别关键。那么就把他开除之后，披头士成为全世界数一数二的乐队。但之后 Pete 在干嘛呢？他去这个试着搞音乐，结果不成功，然后就去当公务员了。做了20年叫 civil servant， 也就是公务员。在之后呢又成立了自己的一个小乐队啊，但成就当然是不大了。所以现在很多人不是专业的乐迷都不知道 Pete Best 这个人。但同样是接受电视采访很多年之后，他却说他过得很快乐，他的生活呢非常的开心幸福。被披头士开除出去呢，其实是他遇到的一个机会。为什么这样说？因为他的被披头士开除之后，他经历一段很长的抑郁。但因为这段时间呢，因为这个事件呢，他认识了自己的妻子叫做 Kathy， 之后他们俩结婚了，然后到现在呢，他们已经有50年的婚姻，生了这个好几个孩子。然后在采访的时候他说，正是感谢这样的一个被开除的经历呢，让他真正遇到了自己的心爱，然后呢拥有了之后几十年的幸福生活。从那个视频的采访看到的照片来看，你可以看到一个非常安详的、非常宁静的、非常平和的一个老人，一个很慈祥的一个老人。但另外那个被 Metallica 开除的 Dave， 虽然是年纪也不惑了，也是很大的年纪了，但是看上去充满了哀怨、不满和愤怒和不甘。那么哪怕他已经拥有了3800万的销量，这个故事让我自己的感受非常的怎么说呢，我的感受非常的深。就像大家知道我在国内做播客呀，或者是做这些这个 就网络上写点东西啊什么的，有很多的听众观众。那么来到国外呢，没有人认识你，很多我在之前一起做播客的同好啊，一起，不能说一起，就和我同一时间一起做播客的一些朋友，他们也取得了很厉害的成就啊，有的朋友创业了，有的朋友成立了自己的品牌。那么有的朋友呢参加了像什么乐队的夏天啊，这些都非常的厉害。那么我在一开始呢，其实心里会感觉到有失落，就是同样是做播客或者同样是这样的一个状态，为什么自己好像是不是来到国外走错了，或者是这个怎么说呢，就是好山好水好寂寞啊，有这样的一个状态。但后来我突然想通了，就是都替他们特别开心特别高兴。第二呢，就是我自己来到这里的收获也是别人没有的，那么收获了再重新活一次的机会，收获了能够在一个新的相对陌生的一个文化环境里面重新开始充实的做自己，收获了新的一些认识的人际关系和朋友，那么收获了另外的一种文化在其中生活的这些经验和体会。说一句比较，我希望我的一些同学没有听到啊，就是我的高中的同学还有初中的同学经常在这个同学的群里面互动，那么大家都在聊聊聊聊那个时候，聊自己初高中时候的那些回忆，当年的那些美好的回忆，现在来看都好像是彩色的，虽然当时那么痛苦，聊聊聊就聊那些东西，但我基本上没有参与他们的讨论，因为我现在有更有趣的生活再去面对，虽然我现在也他妈人到中年了啊，所以这种感受会让你觉得事情可能经历是一样的，还是看自己选择用什么样的方式去面对去看待，也就是我们上一期读书的节目曾经讲到的 Man's search for meaning, How do you choose your attitude towards the extreme environment?好的，那么这就是今天要分享的这本书，叫做The Subtle Art of Not Giving a Fuck. Choose your struggle. Choose your value. And try to do something different. This is what I've learned from this book. And also, do something. Action is not only the result.Of the motivation, but also the cause of it. So sometimes you got inspiration, and then you do things. And then you got the motivation to do things, and then you do things. You action. Actually, it's a loop. 怎么说呢？怎么突然跳到英文了啊？待会儿我们再讲，用英文讲一遍。就是说，这本书里还讲到一个很有意思的点，就是做事法则。也就是说去做事去做出行动，有的时候并不是被激励的一个结果，可能也是激励本身的一个原因。怎么去理解呢？就是有的时候你去有动力，接受了一个动力，受到了启发，有了动力，然后就去行动，是吧？行动本身会加强你的这种动力，那么又有动力，你又再去行动，然后呢又再有动力，那么这是一个正向的循环。所以很多时候不要想那么多，就去 do something. OK, this is the do something law. Alright, so 这就是这本书。那么希望大家喜欢，如果你有任何感受和体会，记得在微信微博和我互动，或者是写邮件啊，写到 bear@beartalking.com。 那么也欢迎在苹果的 iPod, iTunes 给我留言，那么如果你觉得喜欢的，记得向其他的朋友推荐。好的，接下来呢，我会用英文再简单讲述一下我对这本书的一些感受。如果你感兴趣的话，可以继续收听。OK, 谢谢您的收听，我们下本书里再见。 拜拜。
I'm a midnight talker, I'm an alley walker, I'm a day late to face, I'm a burnout quick pace, I am a head case, I am the color of boom, there's never arriving yet you are the opera, always on time and in tune.I am the color of boom. All my life I've been living in the fast lane. Can't slow down, I'm a rolling freight train. One more time, gotta start all over. Can't slow down, I'm a lone.
Hello everyone, this is Bear at Bear Talking. Today I'm gonna introduce a book about the value of your life, about the meaning of your life. But actually, the bookdid it in a very unusual way. The name of the book, The Subtle Art of Not Giving a Fuck by Mark Manson. Actually, it's a few months ago I interviewed the creative director at Rome Creative, which is an agency at New Zealand, here in New Zealand, the creative director, Lucas Coelho. He said, sometimes we just choose the lifestyle. We want to choose the lifestyle, but we forget to choose the struggle for that lifestyle. At that time, I thought, wow, this guy was really smart. But then after reading The Subtle Art of Not Giving a Fuck, I realized, okay, this is not his original. The book reveals this opinion first. Yeah, so sometimes told us it's really helpful to read some books, right? So this book reveals a very important question, like who you are by choosing the things you're willing to struggle. And it's about...to choose something you really would to give a fuck. So even the title of the book is about not giving a fuck, but actually it's about how to find the things you would like to give a fuck and really pay your attention on that. So who's the author? The author, Mark Manson, is a dating coach, a blogger, and a digital nomad.Sounds quite different from other typical author for life suggestion, right? Yeah, but I actually think what he mentioned in this book is really helpful. Yeah, it's like the dirty version or the easy understanding version ofMan's Search for Meaning by Victor, which I introduced to you in my last episode. But yeah, because it's also the same, like you need to choose the struggle and also you need to choose the value of your life. And for the struggle, Mark shares a lot of stories during this book, but I really want to pick one for you. It's likeA man named Dave was kicked by his band, and another man named Pete was also kicked by his band too. So both these two bands become so popular, like the world first class bands. But these two guys, their feeling about their life, their attitude about their life is totally different, even though they did something different in their life. So Dave Mustaine, he was kicked out by Metallica, the most popular heavy metal band. So after that, he decided to create another band, found another band to fight, to prove that he can do better in music industry, and which he did do something really incredible. The band he created, Megadeth,was a very successful heavy metal band, and they sold 38 million copies all over the world, which is an achievement that some guy in the musical industry can never achieve, right? But he's really unhappy because Metallica did the best and he was always the second. During a television interview, he cried in front of camera of what he feels, of what he's feeling when he was kicked out by Metallica. He still feel quite unhappy at that time. And the other guy, Pete Best, was kicked out by the Beatles. And after kicked out by Beatles become the world's first the first band of the world, like the most popular band of the world. And Pete, he couldn't do something better than Beatles, right? And he couldn't even find another chance to build his music career. So he took a civil servant role in the local government for 20 years. And after that, he founded a personal band and just enjoying the music. Seems not achieved as Dave, right? Dave created a band, sold 38 million copies, but Pete just created another band and do some civil servant job for 20 years. But during another interview for Pete, he seems so happy, and also he said be kicked out by Beatles is one of the most best things he ever experienced in his life. Why? And he is not telling a lie. You can see it from his face that he is really enjoying his life. Why? Because he said after being kicked out by Beatles, he was depressed at that time, and it was a tough time. But because of that, he met his wife, Kathy, and then they married and lost four. They went another 50 years of marriage, was very happy, and they have a few kids. And he really thankful that experience brought him to Kathy. So I think that's the difference of attitude we have when we face the life. When we even face the similar experience, the attitude to face it will be totally different results. So this is like another way to show what I've learned from the previous book, Man's Search for Meaning, right? Yeah, so this is a really good example. Actually, I have some similar experience, like when I moved to New Zealand from China. Before that, in China, I host a podcast with thousands of subscribers and listeners. And also, I lose some opportunities to make it become a bigger influence channel. So now, sometimes when I check the social media and found the same podcaster, some podcaster friends in China, they are doing really great in podcasting. But for me, it's become more related to English, to book reading, not a popular topic anymore. But now I do think this is a great opportunity for me, and I'm really thankful for this opportunity to go to a different culture and to start a different life here, which you can experience something you will never dream to experience in your 20s or when you are really young. And every day seems a brand new day for me, even I'm nearly 40. Right, so this is like a gift for me. So I have nothing to complain and really enjoying it. Right, so this is the book, The Subtle Art of Not Giving a Fuck. If you are interested, I highly suggest that you can read it and find your own meaning. What I actually also learned from this book is about do something, right? So it's about action is not only the result of motivation, but also the cause of it. How to understand that? It's like sometimes you got inspiration from something, so you got motivation from someone and want to do something, want to take the action. But after you do something, the action itself will enforce, will make it stronger, will build the motivation to you. So it's like a up spiral. So when you do something, you have more confidence to do something, and you can do it better. And next time you're doing it, because you have more confidence and you can do it better, you're more willing to do that. And after doing that, you get more confident to do that, right? So it's like a up spiral. So this is what we should do in our daily life. So life is imperfect, imperfection. So don't expect to do something perfect. Just start doing that. Start to do that, and you'll definitely learn something. And then, yeah, it's go up. Right. So this is what I've also learned from this book. Thank you very much for listening, and hope you like it. If you have any comments, please share it with me on email bell@belltalking.com, or share it in other social media channel. And I'm looking forward to see your comment or your feedback. Right, and I'll see you in another episode. Bye. Well, I'm gonna get-